They're on their way. We have the director of the game, Mr. Hiroshi Ogawa. And we also have the voice of Victor, Mr. Crispin Freeman. We have the voice of Miki Sylvester, Eden Regal. The voice of Relia, Tessa Netting. And the voice of Anne, Miss Erica Luttrell. The voice of Fiore Brunelli, Miss Amay Castle. And the voice of the rogue Emerson, Mr. Christopher Corey Smith. Okay, let's have a seat. Let's get into it, guys. Just so you all know, there will be a time for a short Q&A at the very end, about 15 minutes. And we'll let you know when you can start lining up. So just to kick things off, I wanted to ask Mr. Kobayashi-san, Mr. Ogawa-san, why it's been 7 years since the last Star Ocean, why now? Why make this new iteration of the game now?
すいません、スターオーシャンって皆さん知ってますかね? すごいずっとですね、7年間くらい新作を作れなかったんですけど、やっぱりスクエアエニックスという会社はRPGの会社ですので、 今ちゃんと新しい形でのスターオーシャンを作りたかったっていうのが一番の目的ですね。でやはりアメリカでもですね、今まで過去シリーズ皆さん楽しんでいただいてたんで、絶対アメリカでは発売したいと思ってたんで、今日集まっていただいたんですごい幸せです。
So it's been 7 years, and we really couldn't release it until now, but because Square Enix is an RPG company, we do make RPGs, I really wanted to create a new Star Ocean right now at this moment. And because all of our previous titles has been accepted really well in America, I wanted to bring it over to the States. And I'm really happy to see everyone here today. Yeah!
Quick follow-up question. So, what you spoke of the previous Star Oceans and this one, what makes this one different than the previous Star Oceans?
よろしくお願いします。今回に関してですが、一番大きく違うところは、シームレスというふうなことにつきるかなというふうに思っております。バトルとイベントというふうな形のつなぎがですね、一応、シームレスというふうな形で作らさせていただいてるんですが、今回、コンセプターの五反田の方でですね、 ダイナミックカットシーンと呼ばれるイベント、シームレスなイベントを作りたいというこのがスタートにありまして、そこをベースに、バトルが シームレスにつながるような形で作らさせていただきました。ただ、過去作の良かったところは残すような形で作っていますので、エンカウントの良さを残した上で、新しい形のスターオーシャンという形で作らさせてもらえたのが良かったのかなと思っております。
The biggest change would be that we incorporated a seamless transition between battles and events and just roaming around on the map. This is because Gotanda, he's from Atreus, he wanted to have the dynamic cutscene incorporated into the game as a seamless cutscene sequence. And that is because, that is why we ended up having all the battle sequences and all the other events seamlessly connected together. But we also wanted to have that kind of RPG feel that we had in our previous titles and to leave the feeling you get when you encounter enemies. And so, that is how, that is the approach we took, and that is what, how we ended up with the game as it is today.
Yeah! So, one more follow-up. What makes this, everyone knows the stories of the previous Star Ocean, what makes this a true Star Ocean story?
あの皆様が、もうすでにあの過去作のスターオーシャンをご存知だと思うんですけども、あの今回のこのスターオーシャンの物語が、まあ、どのように、まあ、なぜ今回も、しっかりスターオーシャンというあのシリーズの中にこう入っていくような物語になるんでしょう。
今回はですね、スターオーシャン3の前の時代 の、 あの物語になってます。ちゃんと、ストーリーというか歴史はちゃんと続いているもので、まあ、多分いろんな作品の伏線になっているようなところを、描いているというようなところを感じてもらえるんじゃないかと思ってます。何にせよ、スターオーシャンとしてトラディショナルな今回は作りにしてます。あえて木を照らった感じのシステムではなく、トラディショナルで遊びやすく、ですが先ほど小川さんが言ってたように、シームレスな要素とかも入れて技術的には新しいものをやってます。安心して遊べて、その世界のつながりも感じられるっていうのが今回のスターオーシャンだと思ってます。
So this, the storyline for Star Ocean 5 takes place before Star Ocean 3 and all the storyline, the history is connected. The exact story is not, you don't need to have played the other titles, but it is the story before Star Ocean 3. And so people who've played the previous titles should be able to feel how it leads up into the different storylines that are in the different Star Ocean series. But we did want to leave the traditional RPG feeling. We wanted to keep it a little traditional and easier to play for new players of the series. So it does feel a little traditional when you play it, but we do have like the seamlessness, and we did incorporate new technologies of this generation.
Yeah! Okay, shift the questioning over to the voice actors. Mr. Crispin Freeman, Eden, and Christopher, I know you've played previous characters in Star Oceans. What was the difference between this version and the previous ones, and what was the experience like?
Ohayou gozaimasu. Sorry. My Japanese is terrible. One of the big differences between working on this as opposed to earlier versions of Star Ocean is that the platform allows so much more detail. When I worked on the earlier Star Oceans, we were limited with how much they could put in the game in terms of voice actors and story and whatnot. And now the computing and storage possibilities of the platforms are so much greater that they can, things can be a lot more nuanced and detailed than they ever were before.
Makes sense. Eden?
Well, this is my first one, so there's...
So what was your experience like?
I agree with that. There was tremendous possibility for... It's a really massive game, and there's so many interpersonal relationships. As an actor, it was really wonderful to be able to tell such a comprehensive story, and the storage capacity, you know, certainly would contribute to that. I loved being a part of it. I felt like there was a lot of attention to performance and to telling the story in a real and emotional way. In addition to the excitement and the adventure and the battles, which are, I think, you know, extremely dramatic and fun, and the transition between the story and the battle will be so seamless that it's going to feel just like this huge, comprehensive tale that you get to experience by going through it. And the arc is really cool. So I was thrilled to be a part of this game and play Miki and be able to tell this awesome story.
That's awesome. Great to hear that. I'm so glad you had a great experience. And how about Christopher?
Well, I'm a little embarrassed to admit this. I just got my mind blown. Until right now, I did not know that Star Ocean 5 takes place before Star Ocean 3. I was in Star Ocean 4. I was Grand Admiral Yuri Gagarin. No, he was the Russian guy.
Yuri Grand.
Anyway, and so now I'm sitting here thinking, wait. This I played that guy, but this takes place before that guy, and now and then before 3, because I was in either 3 or 2, as well as that character you may remember, Utility. I think he's in a lot of stuff. Look at
that guy.
Google it. It was a tremendously fun experience to work on this particular Star Ocean. Emerson's such a great character. I had a blast with him, and I would come in and I would get to hear all the other clips that everybody else had been doing over either that day or the previous days that I got to work off of. And everybody's just so wonderful. This cast is so amazing. They did a great job assembling us, and I am really honored to be a part of it.
And also, like Eden, who is new to the series, Tessa, Ame, and Eric are also new to the series. Let's welcome them to the show. So you're new to the Star Ocean universe. Do you have any fun stories from the recording session?
I'll go. Hi guys. This is actually my first time ever recording a video game ever.
Yeah.
So it was blowing my mind in all the best ways. And Rilia, she is so cute and so small, and she has to like run up to catch up to everyone else. And I just remember how many times I had to say the word Fidel. I had to say his name probably like 100 different times, like in different ways. Fidel, like every way you can imagine. And also, I just really loved Rilia's relationships with all the other characters in the game and how they sort of brought out her personality. Because at first she was so shy, but then when she like meets this whole family, and it's just like joining this new voiceover family. So it was a great experience. I loved it so much. So, thank you guys for having me.
I grabbed the mic first, so I guess I'm going next. I had a blast recording Star Ocean. It was so amazing. One kind of hilarious moment, I mean, I had so many kind of fight terms that I used. One of them, hilariously, I'm not sure if they ended up using it, was hammer time. Like, the soundboard guy who I was working with during that session, when I came back the next day, like edited it into MC Hammer's.
That's amazing.
It was hilarious. I couldn't stop laughing. So I had a blast. Again, yes, great cast. It's such a beautiful game. I mean, seeing all of it after the fact, I was blown away. So yeah, I had a great time.
Hi everyone, I'm Amy Castle, I play Fiore. Woo! Yes, that's what I thought when I saw. So it's really funny because usually when you get a breakdown as an actor for an audition, you're seeing it in black and white. And when I first saw Fiore, I thought, okay, like cool costume, you know, nice skirt, big hat. She had these like diamonds on her legs, so I thought they were really nice tights. And then when I got to the session and I saw her in color and I realized that it was skin, it took on a whole other level. So thank you to Akiman for designing such a beautiful character. A character that I know men everywhere are going to be very grateful for, because there's going to be a lot of cosplay. Every tweet I get is about, you know, her costume. And it was just so much fun to play, and then to see that she had a tail on top of it was, you know, that put it over the top. So we just had fun every single day, and it was, you know, again, great to be a part of such a fun cast, and yeah.
Speaking of Akiman and the character design, these fantastic voice actors embody. The characters are very anime-oriented now, and as the audience can tell by the footage and also the posters that they got when they're on their way in, how did you come to the decision to create them this way versus like a more realistic design?
Akiman-san, ですけれども、はい、今回の、スターオーシャン5のキャラクターというのはどちらかというとアニメ調であるという、はい、感じられますが、前作の、スターオーシャンのラストホープの、よりリアルな雰囲気ではなく、今回 の、 そのアニメ調の雰囲気にされた理由とは何でしたか。
プロデューサーさんの方から、3を今回の雰囲気を3の雰囲気だというふうに聞いたので、といっても4もなんだかんだアニメ的なアプローチがあったと思うんですけども、シェーダー的な問題とかそういうことがあって、ちょっとリアルっぽくなりましたけども、もともと日本の JRPG はやっぱりこの日本のアニメとか漫画文化で培ったこの様式美みたいなものが根幹となっているので、今回もそれになぞらえてやりつつも、あと PS4 というハイディテールが可能なマシンに合わせるように、要は漫画チックなのとリアルなものの中間ぐらいで実在感が出せればいいなという、そういう感じでアプローチしようと思います。
So, definitely because the producer wanted to have characters that were closer to the image of Star Ocean 3. Now Star Ocean 4 still took an anime-like approach, but with shaders and whatnot that went in, it ended up being a little bit more realistic. But just JRPGs in general, it's all based off of the aesthetics that we grew up with the Japanese anime and manga culture, and so it does skew towards it's more of an anime type art. But this time, because it is on a PS4 and it's a high detailed machine, I try to have something that's in between like manga and like realistic art. And that is the approach that I took.
So speaking of the difficulties of the design, shifting back to the voice actors, what were some of the, and this is open to all of you, what were some of the difficulties in bringing originally Japanese voice to, and creating an English voice for it?
Matching the time. Because obviously the languages are so different, so we actually had to match the timestamp, obviously, of the moving mouths and the moving action of already the Japanese recorded voices. And so it was just kind of like, okay, you have a minute and 32 seconds. All right, just like incorporate emotion in that amount of time. It was intense, but an adventure.
It's also a challenge.
Whenever we have to dub something from Japanese into English, there's the question of what is the process. And sometimes what will happen is, we can do it just whatever feels right in terms of timing. Sometimes we are told it must be no longer than this amount of time because that's how it's done, and so if it's shorter, that's okay, but it can't be longer. For Star Ocean 5, we had to match the exact timing of the Japanese line within like 0.2 seconds, I think?
Yeah.
This causes a sort of left-right brain shuffle in your head, trying to maintain both the technical accuracy of the timing, but without losing the emotional performance of what you're trying to do. So it's some of the most difficult acting that I know is out there. I mean, this is like opera or musical theater, where you have to match the timing of something precisely and be emotionally believable, but that was 0.2 seconds too long, so we gotta do it again, you know? And so, That can be really challenging and trying, but when you get it, it really works and it's satisfying. So I know for me, when we finally nail it, it's sort of worth it for the effort that we have to put in to get it just so.
If I can just add, I'm sure that all the voice actors on the stage have an amazing now sense of what exactly 1/10 or 0.2 seconds is. Like, I felt at times that I was a human metronome, that I would do a take and say, oh, it's 0.1 too long, we have to do it again. It was extremely technically challenging, but in the recording process, we never ever lost focus on what was important, which was performance. And so they were very generous with the amount of time that we could take to get a line just right, in terms of intonation, the emotional context for it, and then also fitting into the technical specifications so that they could get the most possible information onto this game, so that we could tell such a huge story. I appreciated that.
Like Crispin was saying, it was very musical for me. While I was recording, especially screams, because screams had to go on for a certain number of seconds, and I found myself sort of doing this like tribal dance, like, so I would get like the thing in my body, and then I would scream and still kind of like keep the beat with my feet, and it kind of worked. So it was sort of finding, it was taking that sort of length of time and finding it in your body, and then it was recording it on top of it and putting the performance on top of it. So it was very technical, but sort of, it got easier once you started doing it. The more that you did it, the more that you sort of felt what was too long, what was too short. But it was satisfying. It was fun.
I don't know if I'm speaking for all of the actors up here, but I think there's also a sense when you're doing a game like this that already has, you know, a different language version, and you're doing the English, you want to create the character and make it your own, but you also want to give a nod to the other voice actor who has, you know, done it previously. And so for me, I felt like the fight scenes particularly were something that I was trying to match. So anything, you know, Fiore had, the Japanese actress had a little bit of a higher pitch than me, so she was like a, yeah! I was like a, yeah! So I would try to match her as well. So like you said, intonation was a big thing too. And then the rest of the time, just trying to create your own character.
Just to follow up on the aspect of timing, I know that all of us have spent a lot of time dubbing anime from Japanese into English, and when you dub anime, obviously you're working with existing picture, and you have to match lip flaps, and what that does is that sort of robs us as actors of imbuing it with our own timing, because we're locked into the timing that already exists in the picture. And so while it was slightly limiting to have to fit our performances into the parameters of ins and outs, it was very nice to be able to imbue our characters with our own sense of personal timing, because we didn't have to match the literal performance that had come before us, and I really had fun with that. I really appreciated that aspect of it. One of the things that was kind of funny was that we all did get really good at matching the timing, and we would try to get as many lines done in a session as possible, and there was always a goal. It's like, oh, you know, Crispin did this much, how many can you do? And so I would come in and I'd be like, all right, I'm gonna do this. Yeah, and there were a couple of times where we got up to whatever the magic number was, and I would go 1, 2, 3 beyond it, and yes, yeah, I got the goal for the day. And I would come back in the next day and they went, nah, Eden came in, she beat you. And that happened like 2 or 3 times with Eden, so I knew that if I was in first and she was coming in after me, that it was gonna be a short-lived victory. I have no idea. I don't know.
I like to think I got the win, but I don't know that for sure. I think that information is probably highly classified, because you the probably. Two of us would duke it out.
That's so funny. I'm going to start having people line up while I ask them this last question for a short Q&A. But the last question to the entire panel is, what are you most excited about for new and old fans alike to experience when they play the game? Yes. So we can start with Kobayashi-san.
今回ま新規、まあ、もそうなんですけど、過去作のスターオーシャンの馴染みのあるプレイヤーに対しても最も体験してほしいと思われることは何ですか？最も体験してほしいっていうことですか？さっき、グラフィックの話もあったと思うんですけど、まあ今回はですね、やっぱりその、JRPG っていうものを考えたときに、
やはり JRPG ってストーリーとかゲームの体験をやはり日本のこうアニメや漫画の文化となぞらえるべきだろうと思ったので、こう広大な、ね、あの空間をあの自分の思い出になる冒険を作るっていうよりもアニメの世界の中の主人公になって、まあ、なんか女の子にチヤホヤされたりとかですね、そういうのが楽しめればいいなと思って今回スターオーシャンを作っておりますので、その辺楽しんでもらえるんだったらいいんじゃないかなと思います。
So there was a talks about graphics earlier, but because JRPG, for JRPGs, I feel that the story or the game is the experience that you want from the game. And it is more based on a Japanese anime and manga. And so instead of creating your own experience, I feel that it should be something that you could become the protagonist. And maybe become popular with girls inside the game, but just have like that kind of experience that you are the main character, and that's what I really want everyone to enjoy in this game.
I was playing Street Fighter, 昔のゲームっていうのはとにかくシンプルなピクセルでできているので、例えばこのおっぱいを描くにしても大した表現できないわけですよ。でも会社辞めてですね、フリーのイラストレーターになったらまたゲームの仕事が来てですね、今度はおっぱいを描こうと思えばですね、めちゃめちゃ綺麗に描けるということが分かりましたので、じゃあまあ細かいことができるんだったらばやろうじゃないかということで、まあちょっと今までできなかったこと、昔できなかったことに対する復讐で結構線多め、アニメって日本のアニメってのは線少ないべきものなんですけども、ゲームだから一回描けばずっと出るんで、細かい感じのものを描けるんだったらばそういうところにも力を入れつつ、まあもちろんデザイン的にはちゃんと目的を持った感じで やってはいるんですが、あのとにかく僕の過去の作品に対する復習的なものみたいなのも、まあ、僕的には見てもらいたいなと思います。
So、I was a creator of Street Fighter before、but games in the past were simple pixels, and you couldn't really try to draw cleavage that well with pixels. But now that now, after I quit Capcom and I became a free illustrator, I found out that I got jobs and I was now able to draw beautiful cleavage for a high-end. So it's like I'm getting revenge at what I couldn't before. And of course, I do, because instead of an anime, this is a game and I could really draw into detail for the characters, and so every single character, I do have concept behind it, but I would be really happy if you really look at the revenge that I got to my
ですね、今回7年ぶりということで、かなり昔のタイトルを遊んでない方にも遊んでいただければなというふうに考えまして、過去作の良かった部分を残しつつ、まあ、今風のテンポ感で遊べるような形で今回ゲームを作ってみました。メインとなる部分としては、まあ、テンポ感よくドライブ感というかですね、割と後先というか行き着く間もなくですね、いろいろな展開が体感できるような形で、ゲームのテンポ感を調整しています。なので、過去作をやったことがない方もですね、戸惑わずに遊べるように作ってみましたので、そういった部分新鮮な形で遊んでいただければ良いのかなというふうに思います。あまり面白いこと言えなくて申し訳ないんですけど、こんな感じでよろしいでしょうか。
お
So since it's been 7 years since the past title, I really wanted to keep what was good in the past titles, but still keep up with the current generation, the feel, the tempo, the driving feel that you get with the current generation game. And so I did want to keep that kind of an experience. And especially for those people who have never played a Star Ocean title, I try to keep it, we try to keep it so that it's really easy to get into. And so whoever has that has not played, I really want you to pick it up and just try the game. And I'm sorry I can't say anything funny, but that is what I really want everyone to experience.
Just so we can get to the Q&A real quick. So if anyone from the voice actors group has quick answers, we can get to those and we'll get to the Q&A.
I just have to say, to be frank, I'm a little worried now because I'm insecure about my own cleavage. So I didn't realize that was going to be so important. So hopefully you'll still enjoy the game.
I'm also most excited about the cleavage. I'm excited for people to deep dive into Miki's nerding out over Signaturgy because she is pretty entertaining in those moments.
I'm really excited for you guys to meet Relia and for you to go on her journey and sort of go with her through this story with all of these friends that she makes, and they help her, and so you can help her too.
I think the word epic is thrown around a lot these days, but I have to say making this game really felt epic, and seeing the game, it feels epic, and I just hope that you have a really epic experience, especially with Fiore's cleavage.
I'm just going to say cleavage. I'm excited for you guys to experience fantasy, adventure, and above all, magic.
Oh. I really think you guys are going to enjoy all of the character interaction. The dialogue is first rate, the characters are first rate. I'm particularly fond of the character interactions between Emerson and Anne. I'd like to take this opportunity to kind of apologize to Erica. Please don't take it personally. I think if Star Ocean 5 had a human resources department, Emerson would be called into it frequently and get lectured. And I dig that. So, cleavage.
On that note, let's kick it off to our first question.
Hi, Ohio gozaimasu. Good morning, everybody. My name is Uri. I'm from Seattle, Washington. And Star Ocean is such a big franchise with so many history and so many different themes and stories. I want to know, what does Star Ocean mean to every one of you? What does that mean to you?
Let's do Kobayashi-san, Nukawa-san.
Ah, なるほど。ですね、僕にとってもスターオーシャンはすごい大きいタイトルで、スターオーシャンがやりたいからスクエアエニックスにいるみたいな感じなんですね。スクエアエニックス、多分僕スターオーシャンをやらなくなったらやめるんじゃないかなってくらいスターオーシャンが好きなんですけど、それをこちらの方でもね、このように楽しんでいただける人たちがいるっていうことが励みなので、まあより新しいものを作っていきたいなと思っています。あとはですね、おっぱいとかお尻とかああいうのがいっぱい出るのがいいと思います。はい。
Star Ocean really is a big title, and I'm actually a big fan of the Star Ocean series as well. And it's not too much to even say that I'm at Square Enix just because I wanted to work on Star Ocean. And like I might even quit Square Enix if the Star Ocean franchise doesn't go well anymore. But I'm just happy to see everyone here like this today, and it really does give me a lot of energy and hope until the future. And I also think that games should have more cleavage and be as well.
Thank
僕はですね、トライエースに入って、初めて制作に携わったのがスター・オーシャン2セカンドストーリーになります。で、それからスター・オーシャン3を作って、ちょっと時間は空いたんですけど、今回スター・オーシャン5に携わらせていただいて、いろいろと先ほどのお二方のお話じゃないんですけど、おっぱいとも含めてですね、気兼ねなく見られるタイトルなので、非常にいつも楽しく作らさせていただいているタイトルになっていますね。なので、その辺の分、趣味が合う方含めて共有できているタイトルかなと思っていますので、まあ、今後もいろいろとやっていければいいのかなというふうには思っています。
So, when I first started at Trice, the first game that I actually worked on was Star Ocean 2, Second Story, and then there was Star Ocean 3, and then now it's been a while, but now Star Ocean 5. And there were some mentions about cleavage this entire time here, but I am able to really put in what I like into this title. They give me a lot of freedom to do what I like with this title, and so I'm really excited to be working on Star Ocean once again, and I really had fun again this time.
Thank you. Hello, my name is Robert Johnson from Chino Hills, California. Until I got really into Star Ocean, I really didn't care for the JRPGs, but Star Ocean just changed my mind completely, and I thank you for making a really great game, and I just hope you guys keep going, because really, I didn't have any care for the JRPGs until I started playing Star Ocean. The third one was awesome.
あのカリフォルニアのチムニルズからいらっしゃった方なんですけども、本当にスターオーシャンがすごい好きで、スターオーシャン遊ぶまでは JRPG に全く興味がなかったそうなんですね。なのでスターオーシャンで本当に人生が変わったと言っても過言ではないと思っています。なので本当にスターオーシャンを作っていただいてありがとうございます。で、スターオーシャン3はもう最高でしたとお伝えしたかったそうです。
Next question.
My name is Wesley. I live in Los Angeles, California. I first played Star Ocean, but I played the fourth one for the PlayStation 3. It was incredibly fun. I also tried the second one, which was also good. But I'm still yet trying to clear the third game. So my question would be, what was the best memorable thing of being part of the Star Ocean universe?
そこからスターオーシャン2をプレイして、今ちょうどスターオーシャン3をクリアしようとしているところみたいです。で、それで皆様の中でスターオーシャンの最も記憶に残っている、一番こう記憶に残っている部分というのはどこでしょうか。
So let's do this. We'll have Kobayashi-san, and then we'll have Crispin and Christopher, since they've been previous Star Ocean as well.
小林さんと声優の方々に。はい、
権利ですか。シリーズで僕はですね、女の子にモテないんですよ。なんですけど、スターオーシャンは女の子に主人公がモテるんで、いろんな女の子にモテる気持ちを楽しむのが、僕はスターオーシャンの中で一番楽しい感じです。
I am actually not popular with girls, but in Star Ocean, you could really enjoy being popular with girls, and that's the really has the best experience with that, and so that's what I like about the Star Ocean series.
I'm not popular with Japanese game developers, but at Star Ocean I get to meet them and be on stage with them. I can tell a little anecdote. When I was working on Star Ocean 3, I believe it was, playing Alvel Knox. Oh, you know him. We broke the recording program. Back then, we still use a program called Pro Tools, and Star Ocean 3 had 14 hours of cutscenes. And they had loaded it all up into one recording session, and as we were recording Owlbell, we got farther and farther into the session until the computer refused to record anymore. It just stopped and gave up and said no. The computer says no. And so, so we had to figure out that the problem was that Pro Tools would not allow you to record anything longer than 12 hours in one session. Because who would ever make a story that's more than 12 hours long? Clearly, they had no experience with JRPGs. So we ended up having to split up the session in order to continue, but yes, we broke the program working on Star Ocean 3.
My hero. Well, first of all, Crispin, I'm convinced that once you work on the cleavage, you'll be much more popular with Japanese game designers. So it can be done. I have to say that the best part of working on Star Ocean 5 was being in this cast. Because you guys are, I don't want to belabor the point, but you guys are amazing. And I'm really, really proud and honored to be among you. One of the interesting things, when I auditioned for Star Ocean 5, they didn't tell me what the project was. I went in and I read for it, and it was Project Red. And that's just the way they refer to it. And I remember going in on the first day of recording, and when I finally saw the script and I realized, oh my God, I'm in Star Ocean. This is incredible, but no one would refer to it as Star Ocean. They still refer to it as Red. In fact, in our contracts, they said, and you must use air quotes when you say Red. And so I would get a call from my agent, and they would say, well, they want to know if you can come in for a recording session for Red. And I'm like, I know what you're talking about. You don't have to use this Red thing. I know what it is, but you know, I'll keep your little secret. So that was just one of the best moments when I realized, when the light bulb went off and I went, oh my God, I'm recording Star Ocean. I'm part of this universe again. And I was so happy to be back.
So we do have time for one more question. Sorry for the rest of you guys. If you do have further questions, we do have a signing with the developers at Kensho Hall at 2 p.m. So see you there. But we do have time for one more question.
Hi, Kudo from Barstow. Other JRPGs, Final Fantasy in particular, are trying to move sort of farther away from traditional RPG formulas, but Star Ocean seems to be trying to evolve sort of inside of the traditional RPG formula. What's the decision process there?
バースト、カリフォルニアのバーストからいらっしゃった方なんですけども、今最近カリフォルニアのファイナルファンタジーシリーズであったりとかは、トラディショナルなJRPGからは少しずつ離れていっているように感じるんですけども、スターオーシャンは逆にそのど真ん中にこう中心にいっているように感じられるんですが、その決断というのはどういうふうにされたのでしょうか。なぜそういうふうにされたのでしょうか。
それ、いろんなメディアの方とかにもよく聞かれたんですけど、今回やっぱり7年ぶりということもあり、昔からこのシリーズを遊んでくれてた人、そして今回新しく遊ぶ人に、極力ですね、戸惑いがなく、あ、これスターオーシャンだなと思ってもらえるように、あえてトラディショナルな道を選びました。で、もちろんですね、開発側としてはもっと新しいチャレンジをいっぱいしたいと。 いうことも強く思っておりまして、今回のスタモーション5を皆さんがですね、遊んでいただいて、少しでも面白いと思っていただけるようでしたら、引き続きですね、今度は全く新しいタイプのものも作ってみたいとは考えています。
Since it's been 7 years, this has been asked by a lot of media as well, but it's been 7 years, and for the
fans from the past and all these new players, we wanted to create a game that doesn't confuse them, so that when you pick it up, the minute you play it, you know that it's Star Ocean. And that is why we went for a more traditional approach this time. It was actually on purpose. But now we want to take on, we do, all the developers do want to take on new challenges. And so if possible, if we are able to do something new again, I really want to do and try ourselves, challenge ourselves to try something completely new next time.
Thank you guys so much for coming to the Star Ocean panel. I want to give, let's give a big round of applause to the entire panel. One last thing, if you guys want to celebrate with us even further, we do have a launch party at Lounge 21 from 5 to 9 tonight, just down the hall, so we'll see you there.